Today we're going to go over hand and wrist positioning for the front squat. And this is something that people love to fight over. In reality, the way that I teach it is that there's no one right way. So we give our athletes and our clients several different options and let them pick what works best for them. I think obviously in maybe the real world, the preference is always going to be to go to the clean grip. I think that's fantastic. We personally don't use it very much simply because of the number of baseball players that we deal with. The wrists, the hands, the elbows, they take a lot of abuse, particularly on our pitchers, but also on our position players who are swinging bats on a regular basis. So I just assume not put a lot of stress on it. But you know, that said, we're going to teach a couple different techniques so you can get the hang of how we actually do teach it. So when I see those who struggle with the clean grip, there are a couple different things that I think are problematic with why they actually do. I think the first issue is some guys try to go with too many fingers on the bar. You can see that it takes a lot more flexibility to go four fingers on as opposed to going with two. So when I actually see someone with a clean grip go with two fingers, I know that they're in a pretty good spot. So if they have two or one on the bar, whatever's comfortable for them, and they're still having some kind of limitations and struggling with it, I know that we're probably dealing with someone who has some limitations, whether it's in, you know, problems with those muscles that cross as both elbow and wrist flexors. You know, they can't get adequate wrist extension. Also, long head of the triceps is a big one too when you're asking someone to both flex the elbow and get into actual shoulder flexion. So that can be a very, very limiting problem there. So that said, if you can't get it with obviously with those four fingers and you go to the two fingers and it still doesn't feel right, it's probably a flexibility issue. So you can either work hard on the flexibility side of things and you know, gradually work your way up to the point that you can do it and, you know, maybe use some other stuff in the meantime, or you can just switch over. So to that end, one of the things that we teach to our baseball guys is we go with the cross face grip. So the way that it's set up, I tell guys, cross your wrists when you're further away from the bar and then go right up so that your thumbs are to the edge of the knurling. So what you'll see where my thumbs are, they're behind the bar. So if I'm gonna squat from this side, my thumbs actually never really get underneath the bar. Instead, they swivel right around so that they're underneath. And what you'll find is as I rack it up, my elbows stay nice and tall, just as if I had my my clean grip going, but you'll see that there isn't actually positioning of my thumbs under the bar. In fact, they're right out in front as if I was here. Okay, so all they are is they're kind of like a gentle reminder to keep that bar right back to my Adam's apple. And as with any front squat variation, if I took the bar right off, or sorry, I took my hands right off the bar, I'd be able to hold it right along that good shelf that I create. Okay, so those are our first two options. And you know, the number one thing to kind of keep in mind is that those elbows need to be almost on a plane with that bar. If they get down too far, it's going to obviously roll on you, whether you're using clean grip or whether you're using crossface grip. I like the crossface for most of our baseball guys. That said, some people like the best of both worlds. I guess you could say, you know, they want to work around the limitations that you get with a clean grip from a flexibility standpoint, but at the same time, they don't like the crossface grip because they don't feel like it gives them enough stability and control over the bar. So they'll go to the kind of the clean grip as straps. So where you set the straps up is right around where the smooth part meets the knurling, and then you just roll underneath, find that comfortable shelf, and walk it right out. And what you'll see is that, you know, you can maintain that elbow position a little bit higher. Why? It doesn't require quite as much extension at the wrist. Likewise, it probably doesn't take quite as much elbow flexion. So you get a little bit of a break in terms of wrist flexibility, but also in terms of what those triceps will allow. So different option. What I will say, I don't feel like guys generally can go quite as heavy with the strap-assisted clean setup. So I generally don't prescribe that very much. That said, we have had some people that have come our way who have done it in the past, and we allow them to stick with it just because it's what they've been comfortable with. For me personally, not a huge difference between what I can clean grip and what I can cross face grip, but I think you will find throughout the general population, people can generally handle a little bit more load with that clean grip. So your big options, clean grip, two fingers, edge of the knurling, dive right underneath, throw those elbows up nice and tall, find your good spot. Option two, cross the wrists, thumbs to the edge of the knurling, drive the elbows up tall, make sure the thumbs are in front, keep the elbows up high. Option three, bring the straps right to the edge of the knurling, drive those elbows up tall, then stand it up. So play around with each of these three and see which one works for you. There isn't necessarily a right or wrong answer. There's just the right fit for each individual person.